So friends, having understood about this dielectric medium and polarization, now in this session, let us pass on to a concept known as polarizability. Polarizability is a parameter. Basically, it is the measure of response of a dielectric medium to the external electric field, and it provides an insight into a molecule's internal structure. It is defined as the dipole moment per unit volume of the crystal cell or per unit volume of the material. That is the polarizability. I would like to make it very clear. Whenever an external electric field is applied over a dielectric medium, the medium gets polarized. To what extent this particular medium gets polarized, it is measured in terms of polarizability. To what extent it gets oriented, to what extent it gets separated and then oriented, that is polarizability. In some cases, even if you apply very large external electric field, the medium cannot be polarized. In such a case, polarizability is zero, or number of dipole moment per unit volume is zero. In some other cases, even if you apply very weak external electric field, polarization may take place, or number of dipole moment per unit volume may be large. So that depends on the property of the molecule, internal structure of the molecule. That is how this polarizability gives us an insight into the molecular internal structure. Basically, it is a measure to what extent a particular medium can be polarized. Let me give an example. If you think of a classroom, even after the entry of the teacher inside the classroom, if the students are not silent or if they are not oriented towards the board, then the polarizability is zero. This is the live example to understand. The moment when the teacher enters inside, if all the students start looking at the board, that is polarization, and there is large polarizability. Anyway, that also depends on students' strength and students, their commitment to the class, their interest, etc. If they are interested, then naturally they get polarized. Now let us pass on to another concept under this dielectric medium, that is the electric flux and electric flux density. As you know, a dipole moment has got plus and minus charges separated by some distance, isn't it? Now whenever you think of the region around the positive charge as well as around the negative charge, there is electric field. So the region around a charge is the electric field. You can also call it as sphere of influence. This electric field is detected by placing a unit positive charge in the region, and the direction of this field is understood as the direction along which the unit positive charge either moves or tends to move. If you think of a direction in which this unit positive charge moves or tends to move, that direction is nothing but electric flux or electric line of force. That is the electric line of force. Therefore, if you place a unit positive charge in an electric field, then naturally there is a direction in which that unit positive charge either gets repelled or attracted, and that line is known as electric line of force. Now, electric flux is defined as total number of electric line of force passing through a given area. If the given charge is stronger, in other words, if the field is stronger, naturally electric flux is large. More number of lines of force pass through the given area. Depending on the strength of the field or the charge, the electric flux also varies. And electric flux density is also known as electric displacement vector. It is defined as the number of electric lines of force passing normally through a unit area. So number of lines of force per unit area is electric flux density, and number of lines of force passing through the given area is electric flux. Both these parameters, electric flux and electric flux density, depend on the strength of the field or strength of the electric charge placed. So these are the two concepts, and these, in terms of these, you can measure the strength of the field, etc. Again, having understood this, now let us pass on to another parameter known as permittivity. The name itself indicates permittivity. It is a measure of permission by the medium. See, permittivity is defined as the ratio of electric displacement vector or electric flux density in the dielectric medium to the applied electric strength. It is measured in terms of Faraday per meter, that is the permittivity. It is a measure of permission offered by the medium for the flow of electric charges. If the permission is zero, permittivity is zero. If the permission is good or green signal is there, then it has got some permittivity. It is the mathematically it is measured as the ratio between electric flux density and the strength of the external field, electric field. So this is how, even if you apply a large electric field, if there is no electric flux density, then the permittivity is zero. The permittivity is the property of the medium. It is a measure of permission offered by the medium for the flow of electric charges. If the medium doesn't give any permission, then permittivity is zero. Again, one more concept, one more parameter with regard to dielectric materials as dielectric constant. Dielectric constant is the ratio between permittivity of the medium to the permittivity of free space. So it is a comparative term. Dielectric constant is a comparative term. Epsilon by epsilon naught is relative permittivity or dielectric constant, ratio between permittivity of the medium and permittivity of free space. Its value changes widely from material to material. In vacuum, this permittivity or dielectric constant is 1. For all other dielectric media, it is more than 1. Understood? And characteristics of the dielectric material are determined by the dielectric constant, and it has no units because it is a ratio. So this is a measure in terms of this dielectric constant or relative permittivity. The properties of the medium are measured, or properties of medium are analyzed. Now, electric susceptibility, another parameter with regard to dielectric materials. It is the degree of polarization of the dielectric material in response to an applied electric field, that is electric susceptibility. To what extent the particular medium is susceptible to the external field. Even if you apply the large electric field, if there is no polarization, then susceptibility is zero. Greater the electric susceptibility, greater the ability of the material to polarize in the response to the applied force. Same example in here also. Whenever a teacher enters inside the class, if there is no polarization at all, if no student looks towards the board, then electric susceptibility is zero. It is the property of the medium. If susceptibility is zero, then the medium cannot be polarized. This is how the property of the medium is also measured in terms of electric susceptibility. So I think with this, it is better to stop here. Other things, types of polarization, etc., that we discuss in the next session.